Hello guys, I'm Shul.
I'm Yuvraj.
And we are going to do unboxing of Moto Z Play, which is one of the latest mobiles introduced by Motorola. And it just hit market 1 month back. So I got it delivered today. I thought I'll do a little unboxing and see what we got over here. Yeah. Shall we?
Yeah, sure. The Moto Z Play comes with the different types of models as you see in the markets or in the websites. So Moto G comes with different types of shells, like the Moto shells is included in that packaging, and other shells you can buy externally, which is like the Incorpio power back shells. Then second one is the JBL sound boost, and third one is the Moto Insta Share projector. So you can use those shells depending upon your requirement. So we'll go by to unboxing the Moto Z.
Just before we actually start with unboxing, I'll just quickly cover what's given on the box over here. So it says that it supports Moto mods and it has got something around 45 hours of battery life, which is pretty awesome. Then it's got 16 megapixel autofocus laser camera, but then we do not get OIS over here, which is optical image stabilization, because of which the image, I mean in terms of video, might be a bit blurry when you're moving a bit. So this is one turn down here, but apart from that, overall the camera is excellent. Apart from that, this model comes with a 32 gigs storage and 3 GB of RAM. And this is powered by Snapdragon 625, which is a performance chip, but it's not the best in the market, but then it is one of the best performing as well, because it gives you a good battery life with good multitasking support. So let's go ahead, let's unbox it.
Sure.
Please.
So as of now, we don't have the tools. So
let me just cut it like that. All sides. Side. All right, I think it's time to come. Great.
So guys, here we are now. It's right. Moto Z Play. As of its package bundle is really good. So it comes with.
Right, so you have to pull it.
Can pull it over here.
Okay, so we get the actual device.
We'll keep it aside and we'll see.
So we'll keep it for later.
Yeah, as we mentioned, we got the one.
Moto mod.
Then.
So this one, as I can see over here, this is really good quality, because it's thick, it's plastic, and the color, as you see, it's. So I always admire something which is a bit darker with that kind of premium feeling. And I feel
something
that
the structure
this,
is very good.
This is really premium. You actually feel good over here with the Moto logo, and it feels really premium. Good with it.
Another thing is like we get the Moto headsets.
This is pretty basic headset.
Yeah.
Nothing special here.
Then USB cable.
Right. Just to add over here, this USB cable is a USB Type-C cable. So it's not the regular USB cable that you see in the market. So this phone supports USB Type-C, which is really appreciable, really, really good, seeing that market is actually focusing and it's transitioning towards using USB Type-C.
And it's a power charger. So good thing is like we get the USB cable and power charger too. So you can use the USB cable while you are using your phone in the office and anywhere. So you can charge it through the laptops or any other USB chargers. And the power charger.
This is Indian retail unit, and obviously the same ejector thing.
Yeah,
I mean, how can you forget that? That is one of the most important things.
It's
right.
Look pretty decent, because it's mentioned as a Moto logo, and they
the
make some pretty much branding regarding the Motos.
Yeah,
this looks good. So we'll keep it aside.
So let's keep the accessories aside and let's focus on the main thing here, and which is. The device itself. Okay, focus, come here. So just keep it here. Looks neat and clean.
As you mentioned on the top of the screen, it's mentioned all the highly tech.
So I'll just read it for you.
Specifications over there.
So it's basically the same that was mentioned on the top. Apart from that, we have an octa-core 3G 3GB RAM processor, and we have fingerprint sensor, 32 gig storage, 3510 milliamp turbo power. Turbo power means you can quick charge. You have quick charge, which means you do a 15 minutes charge, you get a 7 hours of battery life, which is amazing. And then you have support for Moto mod, and one Moto mod comes with it. We have 15 megapixel rear camera, 5 megapixel front camera, and I tell you, the 5 megapixel front camera is coming with a flash. So which is really good. So I'll just guys, I just have to say one thing. This device, although it's not the premium one, this is Moto Z Play. The premium phone that Moto is offering is Moto Z. But then the moment you hold this device, it feels so premium.
It looks awesome.
The design, the mesh,
very premium.
Yeah, the corners, the angles, and the backside also.
The bezels are
how it is
clean.
Yeah.
They are shaped, and it's really friendly to the fingers to hold it.
Yeah,
it's,
sure.
It's,
and it's
this,
all
this
the Moto mod connectors
really
over here.
Grip.
So whenever you connect, use any mod, so they will communicate with you over these connection stuffs over there. Okay. Camera with a dual light LED flash over here.
So this is dual tone
dual
LED
tone,
flash. And
dual tone LED flash.
This is something that is becoming a real standard when it comes to any high end mobile nowadays.
Sure.
Let's remove this plastic flap and let's see how the front looks. So just to tell you about the screen, this is 5.5 inch screen. And this is
having an IPS display, I think. So.
No, this is not IPS.
Yeah.
So this is the good part here. We have an AMOLED display here.
AMOLED display.
Yes.
Yeah.
So we have an AMOLED display here, which is a really good thing considering the fact that this is Moto Z Play. But then they have not used the IPS, which I think is a really good thing because first of all, AMOLED displays, they have very good contrast ratios, and apart from that, they consume really less power. So one of the main reasons why they say that it's got 40-45 hours of battery backup is because they are using AMOLED display to it.
Yeah.
So this is really good feature.
Shall we begin?
Just switch on the device.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Moto with Android. Let's focus more for the viewers. So let it do the first boot in front of you. So while it's booting, so it's Lenovo
branding.
Powered
by Lenovo, right.
As you all know. So what I'll do is, I'll just see how this mod get attached. And that's it. That's really
yeah,
it.
All done.
So it's basically magnetic. I cannot find a surface to pull it, which is a good thing considering that this is a self-sticking back, but I'm not sure how to get it out. We'll see that later. But then I tell you, the back looks
premium.
Awesome.
It's
good. Although I was always skeptical about this big camera projection that they have given. I mean, this is something that you will not see anywhere. But then it doesn't look good. I mean, that bad. It looks good. It looks really good. And then we have an opening for the mic here. And then we have a USB Type-C with a 3.5 mm
jack.
Nothing this side. We have a little bezel here for the power button, a volume low up. And then the SIM and the SD card comes here. And one good thing about this mobile is it's a dual SIM with a separate SD card. So it's not a dual SIM with one acting as both SIM card or SD cards. Everything is different, which is good, which is really, really good. So we'll start it. Right. So select your language, English, next. Select the Wi-Fi. Shall I? Maybe we'll do that later.
Yeah.
Skip anyway. About your privacy, accept and continue. Date and time, I'll just do the standards. Adding your name allows your phone to personalize some apps. So I'll just add my name here. It's a good feeling to type. Next. Set of fingerprint, I'll do that later. Skip anyway. Help find your location, improve location accuracy, help improve Android experience. I don't want to participate for that. I don't want extra data consumption. Wallpaper, widget, setting, everything, and we got the home screen. I tell you, it looks super clean. It's glitch free.
And it comes with marshmallow, right?
Yes,
yeah,
it does.
Marshmallow 6.0.
So there's no physical button here. Just one button here. This is basically the fingerprint sensor. And it acts as a home screen as well. But then we have screen buttons, which you can use for back options and home. And then we have, so basically this phone is pretty much stock Android, as you can see. And
with preloaded apps.
Yes, yeah. It's got the Google apps preloaded. It looks good, looks clean. And I think we'll end our unboxing video here. And let's see if I can give you a video on how it feels, my overall experience using it for say 10 days.
Yeah.
We'll do a video after 10 days, see how I feel about this phone, and let's give you detailed feedback then. Thank you guys.
Thank you guys.
Cheers.